The topic is magnetic flux density and the introduction of Maxwell's equation. In magnetostatics, the magnetic flux density is denoted by B vector and it is equals to mu naught H vector. It is similar to the electric flux density D vector, which is equals to epsilon naught E vector. Here, E vector is called electric field intensity and H vector is called magnetic field intensity and D is called electric flux density and B vector is called magnetic flux density. In case of magnetic flux density, there is a constant that is called mu naught and it is called permeability of free space. Its unit is Henry per meter. In case of electrostatic, epsilon naught is a constant and it is called permittivity of free space and its unit is farad per meter. So this is a similarity of magnetic flux density and electric flux density. In case of electric flux density, the unit is coulomb per meter square, while in magnetic flux density, the unit is Weber per meter square. Here Weber is the unit of magnetic flux. So the constant mu naught is called a permeability of free space and its unit is Henry per meter. In free space, the mu naught is 4 pi into 10 to power minus 7 Henry per meter. So we use the value of mu naught, that is 4 pi into 10 to power minus 7 in case of free space. Just like a epsilon naught, its value is 8.854 into 10 to power minus 12 or approximate 10, that is 10 to power minus 9 upon 36 pi farad per meter. So here we take a permeability of free space, that is 4 pi into 10 to power minus 7 Henry per meter. Now the magnetic flux density is related to the magnetic flux. Just like a electric flux density which is related to electric flux. In case of electric flux, the electric flux is denoted by surface integration d dot ds and its unit is coulomb. So we get a unit of electric flux density d, that is coulomb per meter square. Similarly, the magnetic flux density is denoted by surface integration B dot ds and its unit is Webers. So, the unit of magnetic flux density B is Weber per meter square. Now, as we know that in case of electrostatics, the electric flux line is originate from some positive charge and terminate to negative charge, means in case of electric flux there is a source point and end point. But in case of magnetic flux lines, there is no beginning or end, means the magnetic flux line are closed. There is no beginning point or end point. So here we represent our magnetic flux lines. How we get a magnetic flux lines? For this, we consider a DC current, a steady current flowing through a conductor. So here we consider a conductor which carries a current I that is coming out of this page. So the current I is coming out of this page and we use a right hand rule. With the help of curl of the finger, we can determine the magnetic flux lines. So here the direction of magnetic flux line is anti-clockwise. So the magnetic flux density B at every point on this closed path makes a tangent with respect to magnetic flux lines. So there is a point which is to be noted that the magnetic flux lines are closed. They have no beginning or end. But in electric flux lines, they have some source point and sink point. Now, in case of magnetic field or magnetostatic field, it is not possible to have isolated magnetic charge or magnetic pole. Since we know that in electrostatic field, we have a isolated charge. Isolated charge means positive charge or negative charge, means only single charge, plus Q or minus Q. So we know that from a Gauss's law, the closed surface integration d dot ds is equals to Q enclosed. So in electrostatic, we can consider an isolated charge. Here, the electric flux lines are not necessarily closed. They have some beginning point or end point, that is source point or sink point. But in case of magnetostatic, that is a magnetic flux lines, they are closed one. And in magnetostatic field, there is no isolated magnetic charge, that is either north pole or south pole. Because here we consider a magnetic having two poles, north pole and south pole. And when we are ready to isolate these two poles, we get a new poles, that is we get a two magnets having north pole and south pole. So it cannot be isolated a magnetic charge. So this is a point to be noted. Isolated magnetic charge does not exist. So in this way, the closed surface integration of B dot ds is equals to zero. Means in case of electrostatic field, the closed surface integration d dot ds equals to q enclosed because there is an isolated charge in case of electrostatic field. But since there is no magnetic charge in magnetostatic field, we can say that the closed surface integration b dot ds equals to zero. This means that the total flux through a closed surface is zero. And this is called a law of conservation of magnetic flux or a Gauss's law for magnetostatic field. So the Gauss's law in electrostatic field is closed surface integration d dot ds equals to q enclosed, and the Gauss's law in magnetostatic field is closed surface integration b dot ds equals to zero. Now in magnetostatic, there is an Ampere's law which gives a Maxwell's equation, that is curl of H equals to J vector. Here J is called current density. But in case of electrostatic, the curl of E is equals to zero. This happens because as we move around a closed path, then the dot product of E and dl is equals to zero, which means that curl of E equals to zero. That means it shows a conservative nature of electric field intensity E. But in case of magnetostatic, that is in case of magnetic field intensity, the curl of H is equals to J vector, and this shows that the magnetic field intensity H is non-conservative in nature. And because there is no isolated magnetic charge, we can say that the surface integration of B dot ds around a closed surface is equals to zero. And because there is an isolated electric charge, we can say that the closed surface integration d dot ds equals to q enclosed, and they are called a Gauss's law. Now there is a point which is to be noted. As we know that the closed surface integration b dot ds equals to zero, now any closed surface defines some volume. So here we can use a divergence theorem. So the divergence theorem is a relationship of closed surface integration and volume integration. So using divergence theorem, we get a closed surface integration B dot ds is equals to volume integration of divergence of vector B into dv, and this is equals to 0. And from here, we get divergence of vector B equals to 0. So, the divergence of B equals to 0 is a fourth Maxwell's equation, and this equation shows the magnetostatic fields have no source or sink, means there is no divergence of the magnetostatic fields, means there is no beginning or end, they are always continuous. The magnetic field lines are always continuous. But in case of electrostatic fields, the divergence of D is equals to volume charge density rho v. So this is a point which is to be noted, that the divergence of magnetic flux density B is equals to 0, means since there is no isolated magnetic charge, and due to that there is no beginning or end of the magnetic flux lines, the magnetic flux lines are always continuous, and this equation is a fourth Maxwell's equation.